Some say the foldable phone is the future, but if you want something slightly more affordable, there's also the dual screen folio form factor. Still, these all have one common issue. When you want to watch a full screen video in the top half of the phone, the second app at the bottom is always stretched out and can become rather unusable. This is where the LG Wing 5G comes in. It's a bizarre phone with a swivel screen that swings upwards to give you a smaller second screen. Having used this phone for about a week now, I can tell you that this is by far my favorite multi-screen phone yet. Let's take a closer look. The LG Wing is essentially a premium mid-range 5G phone featuring a Qualcomm Snapdragon 765G processor, triple rear cameras, a pop-up selfie camera, and an under-screen fingerprint reader. It's a little thicker and noticeably heavier than other flagship phones, but it's still more portable than a dual-screen phone like the Velvet. The color I received here is the Illusion Sky, which has a chic gradient finish underneath this frosted glass, and I really like it. Of course, the Wing is all about its swivel screen, which features a 6.8-inch POLED panel. Once you push it up from the right, the phone turns into a T-shape, and you see this smaller 3.9-inch second screen below. This is a great combination for me because I can fully utilize that big vibrant display for watching video while simultaneously scrolling through, say, Twitter or Facebook below without the interface all stretched out. LG says the swivel hinge lasts for over 200,000 swivels, which works out to be over 18 years of usage if you swivel 30 times a day. I do find it tempting to just casually flick the screen up and down as if it's some sort of big fidget toy. There's just something really satisfying about feeling the springs pulling the screen up before the hydraulic damper kicking in to slow it down. And of course, this is also a great piece of kit for showing off. Even though my Wing is a pre-production unit, the software feels pretty well finished. I can set up multi-app shortcuts to launch two pre-selected apps with a single tap, and these tend to have YouTube running on the horizontal main screen with Facebook, Twitter, or Chrome on the bottom screen. I can even put the second screen to sleep so that I can use the phone's body as a more comfortable grip while watching videos on the landscape main screen. It's worth pointing out that even in this swivel mode, you can hold this T-shaped phone in any orientation you want, so that you can use the main screen in portrait for, say, social media, with the second screen sticking out on either side for maybe video or navigation. And if you really want to, you can run a third app on the main screen using the multi-window mode. In all cases, the apps run smoothly alongside each other, though they can sometimes take almost 2 seconds to rotate with the phone. Some apps can even be extended to both screens on the Wing. These include the Gallery app, which keeps the thumbnails on the second screen, and the Video Editor also uses the second screen to show the timeline and editing tools. The Camera app even has two special features reserved for the Wing's swivel mode. First of all, there's the Gimbal mode, which uses digital cropping and electronic stabilization to mimic the smooth panning motion of a mechanical handheld gimbal, and this is all done via the Wing's 12-megapixel ultra-wide big pixel camera. There's a virtual joystick on the second screen for panning and tilting, but the camera on the back doesn't actually move. It's all digital. But to be frank, it seems a little gimmicky, but it does offer free stabilization options which may come in handy when you're walking or running. The second camera mode that uses both screens is dual recording, which is basically the same idea as Nokia's Bofies feature. Here, it captures footage from both the 32-megapixel pop-up selfie camera and the 12-megapixel rear camera at the same time. You can pick either a split view output or have a picture-in-picture format, both of which may make fun videos when we eventually get to travel again. There are some third-party apps that can run on both screens as well. One of these is YouTube, which offers video control buttons on the second screen. Then there's Naver's Whale web browser, which automatically casts any video embed on the current web page to the main screen, while letting you continue browsing on the second screen. As for gaming, Asphalt 9 Legends uses the second screen to show the race map, but we've already seen this on the TwinView docks for Asus's ROG phones. As much as I like the LG Wing, there's definitely space for improvement. For one, I wish LG would give us the option to use the bottom screen for typing onto the landscape top screen, because typing on a stretched out keyboard is awkward, let alone when you're holding onto the swivel screen to do so. Another issue that I came across is how the bundled hard case leaves the swivel screen fully exposed, likely because that part is too slim. Sadly, my phone managed to slip out of my pocket once, and it ended up with some light scratches plus a tiny dent. I was just glad that the phone wasn't in swivel mode when it dropped, otherwise that would have gone very bad. On a more positive note though, the Wing does have IP54 rating for dust and water resistance, which is a little surprising given its structure. For me, the Wing makes an even stronger case for dual screen phones. It's surprisingly practical, it's more compact than its sibling devices, and it's just delightfully weird. But if LG ever plans on making a Wing 2, it'd be nice to have a slightly longer second screen, and maybe it could shed a few grams as well. Do you think LG is heading in the right direction with the Wing 5G? Let us know your thoughts in the comments, and as always, do subscribe to Engadget for more smartphone reviews.